चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्याय गौरक्ति गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो भक्त्या विहीनापराधलक्ष्यै चित्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वं शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणा तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तन्मे मां चरणन्ति। फ्रॉम दिल्ली एंड कलकत्ता, फ्रॉम मथुरा, फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर दिस प्लेसेस सो मेनी डिवोटीज आर hankering that you are today far away from us. They are weeping. I told that I am also with you there. Don't weep. My heartly blessings for you. Here also new good devotees like Gandharva. Gandharva, you know?
Very good singers
and very beautiful ladies of goddesses.
Yeah, they
are coming from heaven or all other places here. All the good devotees like goddesses, demigods, they are coming here, joining our classes, and they are so inspired that it may be that in next they can, in future, they will go to Vrindavan and Navadvip Dham. And then you can see how good devotees are here. I'm not thinking that I'm in so far away from India. Always saying that I'm in Vrindavan with you all. So today is auspicious, not today only. All the days are auspicious when we chant, remember and meditate Gaur Nityananda Prabhu or Krishna or Srimati Radhika or Vrindavan or Navadvip Dham. I am remembering a day with my Gurudev when he was in preaching tour and we very four or five were with him. Pujyapad Bhaman Maharaj, my elder god brother, and some, myself and two other more, we disciples were with him. We were touring in South Bengal on foot, walking more than 10 miles here and there, collecting some rice for Navadvip Dham Parikrama. I think that more than 15,000 pilgrims used to come in our Navadvip Dham Parikrama at the time of Gaur Purnima. Now it is coming. I will, from direct, from my tour, I will go to Navadvip Dham. So we were collecting some donation of rice. And person he used to give so much happily. When we were going, then the minister of Bengal with 100 persons, officers and all other, was also touring in that place. He met at once in way. And he called, he told our Guruji that why you are coming here? He told that we are coming to preach Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Oh, you are not seeing that this area is badly
flooded,
full of flood, water. Everything they have lost, their houses and their rices, everything, their rice field has been ruined by flood. Why you are not helping them? And you are coming to preach Hare Krishna and to collect some rice from here. You should collect rice from all other parts and help them. At once Gurudev told him that where is flood? You are not seeing? No, I am not seeing here flood. All has been drowned in flood. He told that I am seeing that cigarettes of your mouth, all taking cigarettes. It has not been
extinguished.
Huh? Then where is flood? You are telling? If the water of the flood has not touched the cigarettes fires, and cigarettes fire is not
extinguished,
then where is flood? I am not seeing. But I see there is a very flood where there is no kirtan. You cannot help these men by rice. They want love, affection, and they need Krishna consciousness. You cannot make them. Again flood will come, but it will not touch your body and cigarettes fire. So give up all these things and then come to help them. We are helping them. You cannot help like us. I realized the mercy of Gurudev. And he preached over a month or two there, everywhere. And all were inspired. None was going to see Prime Minister, that minister, Indian minister. But all gathering about 10,000, 20,000 in a place to hear our Gurudev. So I saw there. And they collected so many rice, 1 kilo, 2 kilo, you know, very little. But it became more than 100 months, hectare or what?
40 kilos.
More than that. In a village. Poor village it become. And they told that, no Swamiji, we will not hear this minister. Because we will go there and we will take Mahaprasadam from this rice. We are not giving to you or anyone, we are giving to Krishna and to help us. Gurudev told that those who are giving one
grain
of rice for this purpose, you will never starve. Lakshmi may
beg on the road.
She can go to road and beg here and there, but you will not never. So I saw that how great and how strong was our Gurudev. So I know that all the devotees, all the shishya, disciples of Srila Prabhupada, Jagat Guru, Nitya Lila, Pravishnam, Vishnu, Parsisham, Bhakti, Siddhan, Saraswati, Goswami Thakur, were so learned, a scholar, so bold, so strong, that one of them can immerse whole world in their Krishna frame. Jane Jane Shakti Dhare Brahmanda Tarite. He is one of the shishya. He was not so well known in India. Never anyone knew him. Swamiji. He has no good gatherings in India. Only one, two persons. But when he came here, he was exalted. And he drowned the whole world. In a few years, I slept with so much mud here and there. He made hippies happy. He made those who were in jungles and forests. He also made shishya from South Africa, black persons. So many things. Like they were wildlife here. And all they became so high class of devotees. So all these disciples of Srila Prabhupada were so qualified. Once I know a sannyasi of shishya, disciple of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta. His name was Aranya Maharaj, first Aranya Maharaj. I have seen him. He was quite illiterate, like Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, knowing nothing to write A, B, C, D or Ka, Kha, Ga, Gha, anything. But he remembered all these slokas which Prabhupada he used everywhere. And very, very high class of a standard of Bengali. Advaya Gyan Partatva, you know, like this he used to. And thousands of persons used to come to hear him. Once he went in East Bengal, where there were so many learned persons, so scholars in Ved, Upanishad, Smriti, you know, Manusmriti and all other things. So learned. And they used to speak in Sanskrit language, having so big turbans like this. Big turbans. They are called Pancharatna. Nyayaratna, Bhattacharya, Kavyatirtha, so many upadhi, you know?
Designation.
They have read to Banaras University, some of Mithila, some of Kanjivaram in Deccan, so all were there. He was preaching that anyone who is chanting Hari name and he is initiated by any authentic, qualified guru. What qualified? No chance of falling down in any birth. Qualified in all scriptures. Have some realization of Krishna. and he had detached with worldly affairs. No lust, no anger, nothing. He has no sufferings and sorrowing. Suffering and sorrow cannot touch them because they don't require any worldly things. So he was preaching that if anyone takes initiation, whether he is Muslim, low caste, out of Indian caste, Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, even he may be Buddha, he may be of European countries, even Eastern countries, even they are taking, were taking flesh, eggs and cow beefs, and if they are taking Harinam, taking initiation from bona fide guru, he is more than Brahmin. He is qualified. In last birth, he has done all these things, Brahmins he was before. He has done all kinds of austerities. Yes, all kinds of qualities of Brahmins and all devotees. So now he has some respect, taste in Harinam. So they are more than Brahmins. They can be given sacred threads, no harm. They can now do anything. They can worship Radha Krishna, Shalagram, Giriraj Govardhan. They are authorized. They were opposing all. They opposed. It cannot be. By birth, anyone is Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, or these things. Those who have taken one time any flesh or all these things, eggs, meat. And those who are not hereditary Brahmin, we don't recognize them as Brahmin. Shudra will be Shudra and all be in which they have taken birth. They began to oppose Maharaj. Then he told that I am challenging you all to come next day, same place. And if I am not agree, then it may be that after 2 or 3 days after, give a date and ready to discuss all these things. They are also challenged, and a date was fixed after 2 days. So many learned persons from Benares in your city and all other famous in his cities, big pandit came towards him to discuss all these things. He was alone, only 5 or 6 brahmacharis. He never called Srila Prabhupada or anyone. He was so bold and strong. He told any brahmachari, I know that brahmachari now, he was, after that he became sannyasi, and after that he has left his body. He told to that brahmachari, oh, Brichandra brahmachari, come on. Bring some bricks, new bricks. What will you do? He threatened, don't ask question, obey me. He bring about 20 to 25 or 50 bricks. Bring new papers and roll. Repeat it. And write on the cover, Rigvaved, Yajurved, Atharva Ved, Sham Ved, Taittiriya, Chandogya Upanishad, Shvetashtra Upanishad, Manusmriti, Srimad Bhagavatam, and all he made so. 50 bricks were ready for all these things writing. Keep it in a very big cart, bullock cart. And they were given in the bullock cart. And he took so big pagri, like this. No? Very big pagri. And he told that, follow me. Bullocks were given in them, and the bullock cart was dragged to follow to that Sabhagriha,
assembly
house where all were assembled. Big one, about 20,000 persons were gathered there to see what is becoming and go, very big discussion in this. He told that in my sight there should be arranged all the books. All were reading. He don't know to read. What is Rig Veda, what is anything, actually. Oh, let's see. All books were, not books, but bricks were arranged like Vedas. He stood up and told, I'm challenging you. If you dare to come and discuss with me, but you will have to tell, you are seeing here is Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda, Athar Veda, and all the epics, Manusmriti, Mahabhagavat, Ramayana, Puran, all are here. You will have to give reference and you will have to show me. Otherwise, I will show. I will give the reference, you can see here. They saw. Oh, he's a very great learned person. And he's challenging, and he has collected all the books here. We have not seen Sam Veda, but we have heard that there is a Sam Veda, Rig Veda, Athar Veda, Yajur Veda. We have never seen. But he has collected all the books here. So become fearful, and they, one by one, flying. All pandits and learned persons. And he again discussed all these things. He told, the shlokas of Bhagavat, Manusmriti, Veda and Upanishad, that those who are chanting Krishna name, they are more learned than any person who knows Samveda, Rigveda, Yajurveda. Because Rigveda, Samveda, or Yajurveda are telling that a son of doctor may not be doctor. A doctor's son, if he is reading engineering, he cannot tell that I am a doctor. So Srimad Bhagavati is telling that jasya lakhanam punso varnabhi vyanjakam yadanyapi drishyate tatte naiva vinirdishe chatur varnam maya srishtam guna karma vibhagasa. He began to recite all the shlokas as a praman. Praman means as
evidence.
Proof. None was to
argue.
And he, on that thing, on the council, axe party. And all were clapping, and all were so much. In Bengal and India, it was very hard to preach at first. Brahman and Pujari of Vrindavan, Pujaris of Navadvip, they are not allowing the associates and disciples of Siddha Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati to enter any temple. because he was the follower of that principle, that anyone in any world, anywhere, any person, so degraded. But if he takes initiation from bona fide guru, he becomes more than Brahmin, and he can do all the things which a Brahmin can do. Those who are not knowing Brahmin, Brahma Tattva, what is Brahma Tattva? Krishna Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, Jiva Tattva, Prima Bhakti Tattva, all the avatars, what is soul, what is illusory maya, why we are coming in illusory maya, we are not this body, those who knows all these things. Actually he is Brahmin. But even knowing all these things, all epics and all other things, if anyone not chanting Hari name, he has no devotional services. Even he may be son of a very learned Brahmin, he is not Brahmin. He is not qualified. He will have to go to hell. But those who are in lower costs, those who are out of caste and creed and anyone, but chanting, remembering. Krishna takes everything from their hands, otherwise not he. He cannot take anything from Brahmins who are not have any devotional service, nor chanting, no belief in Krishna, in God. You know Raman, Kumbhakaran, they were sons of Brahmins, learned persons. They were rejected. Kansa also a Kshatriya, but he is called demon. Ramchandra went to South India, and a very low caste lady, old Shabari named, he gave his own remnant to Ram, and Ram took it. You know Krishna, wherever he went, if anyone chanting Krishna, remembering Krishna, no caste and creed. He used to become in Achyut Gotra. You know Achyut Gotra? The Gotra of Krishna. The caste of Krishna. The creed of Krishna. That is why, wherever we go, if there are devotees having faith in Krishna and chanting and remembering Krishna, we take their cookings, we can offer to deities. But even today, Indian learned persons of Vedas Upanishad, if they are initiating to any person, but if he is not Brahmin, they will not take a water also, even.
Touched by them.
So, Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, he sent so many disciples to Western countries also. So many persons came, but Param Pujyapad, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, taking sannyas from our Gurudev Nitya Lila Pravishtong Vishnu Parsisun Bhakti Pragyan Kesha Goswami Maharaj, he came to Western countries. And as a magic, he preached all over the world. Now we are seeing that those who are here, also they anyhow they were connected with Swamiji. They are inspired by reading his books, by his devotees. He preached over whole world. Very soon, with Nagar Sankirtan, Bhakti Vinod Thakur Namhat Sankirtan, and thus in whole world devotions are going on. So if you want to do Guru Seva, this is essential, to obey him and to help others, that they should be changed by the heart, not only changing food and all other things. They should be changed in all ways. Their hearts should be changed from material Russia to
transcendental
bhakti rush, prem rush. This is most high class of guru service. Guru wants this. He does not want that, oh, my disciples should come and message me and cook for me, only do for me, don't go to any Vaishnava. He will tell that you can serve any good Vaishnava. You can associate. If you are not associating with any qualified Vaishnava, more revealed than you, you cannot progress. And that is why I see that where Swamiji went, his disciple went, they inspired and so many disciples came. But after that, they left all and they were dried. No? So I want that you should always be in good association. Create good associations yourself. For this you will have to give up your mean-minded. Be broad-minded. You should always, those who are chanting, remembering, all are in our Gaur Parivar, Krishna Parivar. Krishna family, Gaur family. Try to honor all who are even not taken initiation but chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. We should honor. Don't think that, oh, he is in that group, Sridhar Maharaj group. Oh, he is in ISKCON group. He is in Maharaj group. Don't.
Don't be sectarian.
Don't be sectarian. Try to chant yourself also, remember, and serve Krishna and Radha and Mahaprabhu, and try to help them also to become bona fide Vaishnava. This is our duty. I want to pray, I want to suggest, give suggestion to my God brothers. I think they are my God brothers, the disciples of Swamiji, that they can glorify Guru Tattva. Why? Prabhu, what name?
Gurukram Prabhu.
Gurukram Prabhu may stand and glorify. Also, I think that who is senior? No harm. After he, Guru Bandha Prabhu Bal, tell any remembrance of his Gurudev and how he preached so quickly and how we should serve Gurudev and the glories of Gurudev from epics or anywhere you can tell. If you want, you can come here. This I will not speak now. I will speak after 25 hours. Baldev Prabhu or Nityanand, who takes it and offer it to the lotus feet of Krishna. So all the gurus bona fide, I am not telling so-called gurus, who one day they are thinking that we are bona fide guru and next day they are falling. I think they are were fallen and even they are falling. So Guru Bhakti, to serving the service of Gurudev, backbone of bhakti. Without this, we cannot enter in bhakti realm. So he told about this. Very good. Now I am requesting a devotee of Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swami, very senior and sincere devotee. His name is
Gopabindapal.
From
distance,
I think from 72, he was serving his Gurudev in so many ways. He is also like a scholar and very qualified Vaishnava. So I am requesting him to glorify Gurudev. And if any remembrance of his Gurudev, he may quote.
Also, Maharaj, you alluded earlier to the idea of the family, the Krishna family, the family of Gaur. And contrary to some opinions, that was also the direction that Srila Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj spoke and gave. Many times you hear different opinions about what he intended, but I can bring up a couple of instances which are very enlightening and which many times we don't hear about. Srila Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj had a very interesting letter exchange that I recall, in which he was asked by Godbrothers in India for cooperation, and his response that he would be the first to cooperate. And those of you who know the letter exchange, then he said, but maybe we have some difference of opinion about Guru. And then almost in the same breath, same letter, same sentence, he caught himself, said, but I don't wish to discuss these things while we have a chance for cooperation. So he was willing to put the differences of opinion behind in order to...
But I want to disturb you. He wrote a letter to our Gurudev and myself also. Gurudev also responded very soon, and he gave a sponsorship letter or what letter, I don't know, that he is one of the devotees of Gauriya Vedanta Samiti, and he has come from our society, and I helped so much. He wanted to that all should cooperate. It may be that all were not cooperating, but I think that all were happy that he is preaching everywhere. Some may be like third class bogus person were not admiring him. But all the sincere devotees must have so much favor for him that he is preaching here and there. We could not know what he is doing. Go.
Hare Krishna. So that, with a careful study, that comes to be the prominent feature of Prabhupada's teaching. Sometimes he qualified here and there, but with careful studying, he was always pushing for cooperation between all branches of the family. And even so much, another letter exchange, some of you may know, when he first came to America, he wrote to Godbrothers, and one thing he said was, if you can help me make a temple here in New York, this was before anything, then this will be your temple, as if like you will be the temple president And he said, and I'll be your temple commander. So his willingness to cooperate and to involve everybody in the Chaitanya family was in fact the prominent part of his teaching. And some details elsewhere sometimes have disturbed us, but the fact is the prominent thing is that. And also, guru means the essence of his teaching. There may be so many relative things according to time and place, but what is the essence, the absolute part of his teaching? And in this case, with Srila Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, his essence is shared by so many others. I know myself, for so many years, trying to struggle and to maintain some devotional clarity, and always keeping some kind of standard, always sort of remaining in the ballpark, but at the same time losing the intense inspiration and taste for the instructions of Gurudev. So he told me, he told everybody, you chant the 16 rounds of Maha Mantra, and you always have Krishna Kirtan, always have Krishna Katha, always try to spread the Krishna consciousness movement, always associate Sadhu Sangha, always offer everything to Krishna, the basic things which are the principles, the pillars of Gaudiya Vaishnavism forever. So he pushed these and pushed them toward us. And sometimes when my personal enthusiasm was waning, I thought, if somehow or other I can follow these things more intensely, if I can become a little more sincere to follow these things, it would be so pleasing to my Guru Maharaj. Then some other Vaishnava comes, and his pravachan or his encouragement helps me to do all those very things. More chanting of Harinam, more Krishna Katha, more Sadhu Sangha, more Prachar, more everything that Prabhupada told me to do. Some other Vaishnava comes and helps me do all those things, and I reject some other Vaishnava? That doesn't make sense. Because the encouragement is toward the same thing that my Diksha Guru gave me. So those Vaishnavas who helped me toward all the things that my Guru Maharaj wanted from me, they are my siksha, teachers, guru. So I know Prabhupada would be happy that we're glorifying Srila Narayan Maharaj here tonight, because he is helping us to go in the direction that we all know Prabhupada wanted of us anyway. So that's all I have to say, except to thank Narayan Maharaj deeply. And he knows he's helped me and my family, especially my wife. And I pray that the preaching will go on and that I can help in some small way. Hare Krishna.
Very good. Appreciate it. Somebody wanted this. That we are in, and we should all serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, Radha Krishna. When he came to Western countries having no farthing, no Indian paisa, one paisa, nothing. Only worn and torn, only Gita book, his three volumes of Srimad Bhagavatam, and other books I sent from India. I sent him so many kartals, so many ditties,
Peda
and all other things, Tulsi Mala,
have written, I sent to him. Also duties. And he wrote me more than 200 letters time to time. I gave it to Satsarup Maharaj to publish. Some of them, the essence of them has been given. He used to so much do mercy upon me. He wanted to engage me always in Krishna service, in Guru service. So I know him very personally. So personally. He gave me such good services. He was loving me from heart of core, I know. And that is why he gave the very secret services. He never gave it to his any disciple nor his god brothers. I was not so much qualified, but so much affection for him and my all Guru Parampara, Thai Guru. He used to know that. He is very bona fide disciple of Krishna Maharaj. So he used to love from beginning. I had so much chance to be with him. So I know his heart also. He told me to help his disciples. At the last day, he took my hands. And that is why I decided that I must go to the places where he has gone and he has preached. Now something waterless, there is the devotees drying like water, lacking of water. So I came to Western countries and now I came here. I am very fortunate to see that all devotees concerned are coming to me. So without cost and greed, I want to give the same water, same love and affection, same all these things. So I want to create that very situation when he came and all were inspired. So now I'm requesting Shamrani Acharya. She is so senior disciple of Swamiji. She has preached everywhere. She is very qualified. I want that even I am not coming, she should come. And being the representative of Swamiji, myself, and Krishna and Gaurachandra, he should preach also. I think that you are so much qualified person. So with a great enthusiasm, you should again be like in the time of Swamiji as we are. Sometimes you may come to India also for higher class of associations. Don't think that we are in any caste and creed and party and this group. So you should tell something.
Charitamrita. Ekupe Ramanda Bhamite Konya Bhagyavana Jeev Guru Krishna Prashade Pai Bhakti Latavij. After wandering throughout millions of universes for millions of births, a very fortunate person gets the seed of bhakti from a bona fide guru. And by the grace of that guru, he gets Krishna. So what does it mean, a fortunate jeev? Does that mean that somebody's just lucky and somebody's unlucky, and it's all haphazard and by chance? Srila Narayan Maharaj gives a very beautiful explanation of this verse in his book, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu Bindhu, which is a translation and commentary on the commentary of Viswanath Chakravarti Thakur of Srila Rupa Goswami's Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. And this book is a sequel to Srila Prabhupada's Nectar of Devotion. Generally, we read in Prabhupada's books the list of stages from beginning to end of bhakti. Ado shraddha, tato sadhu sangha, tato bhajana kriya. First there's some faith that what is this Krishna consciousness movement? Let me come and sit down. Ado shraddha, tato sadhu sangha. Then I associate with elevated devotees, and out of those, I select one as my spiritual master and perform regulated devotional service under his direction, bhajana kriya. Then, by following those instructions, I become free from anarthas or impediments to bhakti, impediments from past sinful activities, impediments from past pious activities, impediments due to offenses, impediments due to improper execution of bhakti. Then I develop some steadiness called nistha. Then I develop some taste. Then that taste turns into attachment, not only, just like now, I may have some attachment for service or for bhajan, but at the stage of attachment or asakti, I develop attachment for Krishna as a person, as natural as a boy for a girl or a girl for a boy. And then comes bhava bhakti or emotional ecstasy in relation to Krishna, and then pure Krishna prema when one enters into the pastimes of Krishna and serves there. So generally we hear that these are the development of stages, beginning with Ado Shraddha and second Sadhu Sangha. But actually, Maharaj explains from Viswanath Chakrabarti Thakur that actually there's a stage, very special stage, very long stage, that's, what do you call it when something's compressed into one word, Ado, Ado Shraddha, first. Ado means first. So Ado, before Shraddha comes Sadhu Sangha, then comes Shraddha, and then again comes Sadhu Sangha. So this fits with the original verse, Ekupe Brahmanda Bhumite Konya Bhagyavana Jeev Guru Krishna Pushade Pai Bhakti Lata Beach. That is, after wandering through many, many universes, in many, many births, the fortunate soul gets the seed of bhakti from a bona fide guru. So how do these two fit? After many, many births of being so fortunate as to have had sadhu sangha, the association of pure devotees in different universes, and followed ekadasi, perhaps not with any knowledge or not with any realization, visiting temples, taking prasadam, visiting the holy places like Vrindavan and Navadvip. By many, many lakhs of births of these, one gets the, these are called sukritis or sanskaras. Sanskar means impression on the heart. Just like somebody off the street may come in on Janmashtami accidentally, so-called accidentally, and celebrate Krishna's birthday. So this makes an impression on his heart. As Srila Maharaj was saying yesterday night or the night before. Suppose, it was in Devendranath's house, that suppose somebody has a Kanistha Adhikari guru, not very qualified guru, but he's practicing some sort of relation to bhakti. So he's getting some impressions on his heart about bhakti, and this may give him the appreciation or desire in his next birth to take or look for a bona fide guru, and at that time in his next birth, get the actual seed of bhakti. Because if one does not have a bona fide guru of the qualities that Maharaj mentioned from the Shastra, that is freed from all material desires, not experiencing any sorrows or suffering, full realization of Krishna, and full knowledge of all the Shastras. He can answer any question about any Shastra and convert others to Vaishnavism. So unless one has a guru on that level, even he may execute everything that looks like bhakti, attending Mangal Arati or chanting, doesn't have actually the seed of bhakti in his heart. But he may get good sanskars and good sukritis so that in a future life he'll develop this urge for a bona fide spiritual master and begin his sadhana bhakti at that point. So this Ekupe Brahmanda Bhomite Konya Bhagyavana Jeev, Bhagyavan, fortunate Jeev, is after many, many millions of births. I remember Srila Maharaj gave one lecture in Navadvip. Perhaps it was at the yoga pit in Navadvip. And he said, you have all come here not by accident or chance or very easily, but after so many millions of births of performing good activities and devotional activities. And sukritis means there are two kinds of good activities, sukarya and sukriti. Sukarya means good material pious activities like opening of hospitals or giving in charity to a poor person. If one does many, many billions of such activities, he doesn't get bhakti. But by performing sukritis, that is devotional activities, knowingly but without devotion or without realization, or even unknowingly, these create impressions on his heart so that at a certain point he develops an urge for a truly qualified spiritual master, and at that point he gets the seed of bhakti. What is the seed of bhakti? What is this shraddha? It's the actual desire to serve Krishna. And that desire is in the beginning, in seed. And on one hand, the guru gives the seed of bhakti because he's like a gardener. On the other side, the seed of bhakti is already in us. Srila Maharaj gave one example from Chaitanya Charitamrita that in the ocean there are, what are those animals that get pearls?
Oysters.
Oysters.
Oyster
shell. Oyster in the oyster shell. So at a certain time, during a certain nakshatra or arrangement of stars, Swati nakshatra? Swati nakshatra. When the rain comes down into the ocean and falls into this oyster, in the oyster shell, and by that a pearl comes into the oyster. So a pearl, if a pearl lands on a dog or if a pearl lands on a starfish, it won't produce the pearl, but it does with the oyster because the oyster has the potency within it. Or a serpent, by that rain, will get a jewel on his head. So according to the particular potency which is inherent in the jiva, the potential, the particular relationship, mellow relationship, any of five, that we have with Krishna, that seed is there eternally in us. Everyone is Nitya Krishna Das. So that seed is eternally in us. But the bona fide spiritual master is like a gardener. This is a very beautiful tropical area, so I'm sure many of you perhaps know about gardening. And a good gardener can look at a seed and tell exactly what kind of plant is going to come out. So a qualified spiritual master can look at any of us, even though we're in the conditioned state and totally covered by anartas, offenses, sins, lust, anger, greed, pride, and so many things, and tell exactly what our spiritual body looks like and exactly what services we have to Krishna. Also, he plants the seed of bhakti, means that he gives the desire to serve Krishna, and by his watering, as Maharaj said, he's giving the same water that Srila Prabhupada gave and is still giving. So by that water, he's watering the seeds. As Srila Maharaj explained in the West, he found that Srila Prabhupada's disciples and followers were so sincere, but Prabhupada planted so many seeds, and now, in 96 he came, and 20 years later, some of the seeds were still seeds, some of the seeds were sprouts, and some of the seeds were little plants, but they were all shriveled up and dried up. So he came to give the water, the same water, he took the water from Prabhupada to pour on the shriveled up little plants, sprouts, and seeds to nourish them by bona fide Harikatha and make that seed or plant grow and grow luxuriously so that it goes beyond all the coverings of the universe and develops fruits and flowers at the lotus feet of Krishna in Goloka Vrindavan and develops a full-fledged spiritual body. So the gardener can look at the seed and see what kind of plant it is and nourish that plant to its full bloom. So it's only after many, many millions of births of good Sukritis and sanskars that we're all here tonight having darshan with Srila Narayan Maharaj. Panchakalpa Charubhyasya Kripa Sindhubhyeva Cha Patitanam Pavanebhyeva.
I'm so much debtor to them. I also so much art debtor to Devendra.
Here, Devendranath is here.
Yes, he is here.
Oh, here.
So much indebted that he dragged me here. They helped me by money and all other things in but he dragged me, oh, you should come to Australia and I will around you and all devotees. And that's what he did. So I cannot repay him. We cannot repay him. So I request him that it may be that we can do some anything against his wish or anything, but he should be so tolerant to Nadapi Sunich. I know that he will do and always cooperate and always encourage me. As he has brought me with so many devotees, he will always encourage me to preach here and there and always help me. After some time, in our last days, we will go again there and we will be there as we were there.
Very well. Very well.
Jai. Om Agyanta Medandasya Gyananjana Salakaya Chakshurun Militam Jaina Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vancha Kopa Tribhyascha Kripa Sindhubhyevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. I always get a little nervous when I have to address a large audience of learned devotees, sincere devotees, so you'll be patient with me, I hope. Despite years of effort, I can only share a few thoughts with you regarding spiritual ideas tonight. I'm not a great scholar, but I will put forth just a couple of thoughts on the occasion. And if you find some value, then maybe you can overlook the incompleteness of my thoughts or whatever faults are there. If we think about today, I was thinking, what way can we sum up the essence of the day? And the thought that came to my mind is, what is love? Is love an aesthetic idea? Is it a state of being? Is it some kind of human condition? How do we know what is love, and how do we find out some experience of love in our lives? I've heard Maharaj speak that if we cannot love someone here in our practical dealings in the material world, how can we expect to develop our love for Sri Krishna and Sri Krishna's very special devotees? I also remember Srila Prabhupada on a number of occasions saying that the best example of love in the material world is the love of the mother. And when I heard that, of course, I was a young brahmachari, and the idea of even recognizing how a woman could have the highest embodiment of love in the material world was anathema to the state of mind that I had at the time. But having passed through many trials of life and different changes, I think, as most of you here have gone through, I've witnessed the love of a mother. And just to give some idea, which I think has great symbolism, it begins at birth and the inconveniences that the woman tolerates in carrying the child. It's very heavy, so many changes in the body, so much pain, great deal of pain. I don't know how many of you have been there for the event, but it's quite shocking, actually. I was there the first time that I experienced it. I almost passed out. And I said, here it is. And after about 36 hours of struggle. That's just the beginning. Then there's about 6 months of absolutely sleepless existence. So many feedings, what is it, 6, 8 times at least a day. Stool, lots of it. Try to keep clean, you take a bath, you put on nice sari, vomit. It's very, very difficult. And it doesn't end in one day. There's no way out. There's no vacation. Oh, let me just put this job on hold while I take a break, and I'll see you in a couple of months. Men get away with a lot, you know, they can just kind of skip out, go to the beach when it gets tough, you know. But the mother has to always be there. And it's years and years and years of trial, giving, giving, giving. Breastfeeding, baby bites, it's painful. No thanks, only asking, 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 and asking more. So the next question that came to my mind is love comfortable? I think love is not comfortable. I think love is very uncomfortable. And I think love means sacrifice, the same kind of giving that a mother gives to the child. Of course, these are mundane examples, but they're very good examples. And when I think of them, I think of the love of my Guru Maharaj. He was a very proper person, born in a proper family, was a gentleman. He knew how to treat people and how to be treated. He was a business person at first, giving everything as much as possible in spiritual life, conducting his business very carefully. So he was a great person of character, even from a mundane point of view. Anyone who met him could not help but be taken by his arresting, gentlemanly behavior. At a very old age, he suffered, as everyone knows. The story's been told so many times, it's so familiar. But let's put ourselves in that situation. Has anyone here suffered a heart attack? Anyone? Okay, so it might be difficult to put ourselves in his situation. Has anyone traveled on a boat in a storm across the Atlantic, in a little box in a boat, cargo boat? One. Very difficult. Two heart attacks. Coming to an unknown country. I've gone to a new country as an unknown person. Very challenging. Some of you here, I know, have done the same. You feel very lonely, don't you? Very much at a loss. And he came with aspirations to help people and preach to very special people, gentlemen, like his Guru Maharaj requested. And in the end, he had to stand in line for the shower, as the hippies and drug addicts and flotsam and jetsam of the 1960s elbowed past him to gain that valuable shower resource in the morning. Stand in line, Swamiji. It's hard to describe. All we can do is think of so many examples. So he took great pains. He made great sacrifices. And I think that if I think of today, I think of the generosity of his heart, and I think of the generosity of great devotees who make their way to us and take so many pains and so many inconveniences and suffer so many insults, so many neglects in order to help us. They're selfless and they're simply trying to bring the beloved back in connection with the lover, Sri Krishna and his jivas. So those are my thoughts, some of my thoughts for the day. I would ask myself, how much am I sacrificing? How much inconvenience? How much vomit and stool and crying and sleeplessness am I taking on in my dealings with other people to serve my Guru Maharaj? And I wouldn't ask you to think the same thing, but it seems a worthy thought. Because I feel that love is generous and generosity is seva. And to sum up, I feel that Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj, once again, thanks Krishna, has come to remind us what sacrifice is and giving is, and care. The mother doesn't need to really get anything back from the child, but just wants to see the child grow and develop into something nice. I feel that from him. I feel that he cares about how we grow and how we develop, so that we can become nice, mature, spiritual people in Gurudev's service. Guru Granth Sahib.
Is so high, so low. But there may be some selfishness because it is bonded. So any good disciple may forget his mother's all these piteous activities towards us. Even we know in scripture, Srimad Bhagavatam and all others, that mother cannot give as a chaste wife can give. Solely, his body, her body also gives. But even remembering the mercy of Gurudev, all forgets everything. Why? No selfishness there. Only mercy and mercy is there. Not to gain anything from disciples. Those who want to gain something, really they are not authentic guru. Never they can. Swamiji came, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, all his associates came, only to give. Samarpayitum unvatal ujjvala shamsi. I will explain this shloka tomorrow. So they can give affection and love, pure affection and love, that in comparison to that, worldly, all affection and love become so
insignificant.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left his wife and mothers. They were weeping so much, but he left. You know Sukadeva Goswami? You know Narada Goswami? Oh. Only this mother, father, friends and wife's affection to child, friend and husband or beloved. Only shadow of that, if there is so much affection, attraction in all these things, in shadow, then how it be in Krishna? That is why when Krishna used to play on floats with cowherd, why with so many lakhs and cows going here and there. Even deers, even bees, wild beasts, he used to follow him. Even at the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he was going to Vrindavan, tigers,
elephants, mad elephants, lions, seagulls, deer, coming in one row, here and there, following Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, seeing the face of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, hearing the beautiful song of Krishna, 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 He, Krishna Keshav, Krishna Keshav, Krishna Keshav, Krishna Keshav, Pahima, Ram Raghav, Ram Raghav, Ram Raghav. So this all have come only to bestow this pure affection for Krishna. So Swamiji has come to give this unalloyed devotion of Krishna to anyone who was coming in front of him. So we should try to again work up, and as we are inspired at that time, all there, we should again be like so, that he will see, he is here, he is seeing, he is everywhere. Mahaprabhu is everywhere, Nityananda Prabhu is everywhere. So he is watching, looking us. And if he will see that again they are doing like so, he will be very, very much glad and happy. I request Prabhu to speak something. I'm so much happy to hear all Udhara Prabhu and all others.
So today is a very, very joyous day for me. I was in Australia for many years, and then I left to spend some time in Vrindavan Dham. And today I feel so much that Sri Vrindavan Dham is manifesting in front of our eyes with the grace of His Holiness Srila Narayan Maharaj. So I'm so grateful that this he could come on this voyage to here and bless us with his heartly blessings, which he is munificently bestowing. He asked us previously to glorify A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. I never met Srila Prabhupada, but I took his instructions to as much to heart as I knew how to. And at a certain stage, I also imbibed the instructions of His Holiness Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Swami. And this, I felt, took me to another stage. But still, the seed had not been lodged within my heart. In Sri Vrindavan Dham, I was endeavoring externally, trying to catch up what is Radha Dasyam, what is service to Guru, how to perform devotional service to Srimati Radhika. But nothing was moving within me until His Holiness Srila Narayan Maharaj blessed me with His mercy to understand a little fragment of the inner truths of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's descent. So without this direct association in the pure line from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we have utterly no hope, in fact. And as has been spoken many times in the last few days, the rarity of this opportunity has been expressed. Srila Narayan Maharaj was saying yesterday, he was talking about a day of Lord Brahma, the different yugas, how in the 28th Manvantari, 8th Manvantari, 28th yuga, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Srila Vyasadeva actually manifest at this time. And the rarity of
that Krishna prema, love for Krishna. In this samsara ocean that we are stuck in, there is a tiny, tiny little door out, and only Guru can pull us through here with affection for Krishna. And Srila Narayan Maharaj was just a few minutes ago, and Buddhara Prabhu were expressing sentiments of affection. And many times when I see Srila Narayan Maharaj talking about his affection for Krishna, he seems to embody to me that affection itself. So he is encouraging us to have that affectionate relationship with himself, to approach Lord Krishna with that clearness of heart and love, which only such an exalted personality can truly show us. I was thinking today that Srila Narayan Maharaj, he began, when he first sat down this evening, mentioning his many other disciples and well-wishers around the world who today would be feeling great separation that he is not with them. And I remember so many occasions in Keshavaji Gaudiya Math and Rup Sanatan, Mandir in Vrindavan, how so many thousands and thousands and thousands of Brijvasis, Mathuravasis, Deliwalas, so many people would come and offer their most heartly well wishes to Srila Narayan Maharaj. So I was remembering this and appreciating how he has come to visit us at this particular time and give his blessings to us to catch up this mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and to become re-inspired in the sadhya to keep the vision of these activities in devotional service. Many years perhaps we perform the activities not being fully aware of the goal, the sadhya. And Srila Narayan Maharaj has mentioned many times in the last few days to focus on Radha and Krishna's pastimes, to focus on Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lilas and his associates, and to capture this mood of service and affection to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his associates, Sri Krishna, Radharani. Today Maharaj was talking about the Dhammadharastikam pastimes with such beauty and wonder that it can only, it must melt the hearts of the stone-like unfortunate people living in the Western worlds, that he has come here to melt us, and I'm just eternally grateful for that. Hare Krishna.
But anyhow, he is inspiring me and also making me courageous, helping in so many ways. All the things. So I am so fortunate and lucky that I am giving something to devotees. Now I request Devendra Prabhu. He has also served Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta. So he will speak some words.
My heart and mind today, I've been going through a lot. But I know that Gurudev has been talking to me, to my heart all day. So I want to apologize, first of all, for the offenses I've caused to all the devotees and to your divine grace. In Mathura, Srila Gurudev told me in the room two things to meditate on for me, Nibbalashita Shunyam and Trinadapi. And I had to stretch it very hard today. Really stretch it. Anyways, my own heart, I was fortunate to spend some time with Srila Prabhupada and travel. And the word dandavat has a certain meaning that you give your full heart. There's no taking back. You've completely give your heart to such a person. And the feelings that I have, this is a very personal thing, for Srila Prabhupada, I share that same feeling, if not stronger, or as strong, for Srila Gurudev. It's hard to express in the heart. But anyways, I wrote a poem, and I'd like to offer it to you. To Srila Gurudev, Radha Krishna's most intimate friend. O Srila Gurudev, the honey dripping from your lotus feet, like from the mouth of a bee, I fall at your feet, you who resemble a desired tree. So close a friend you were to Srila Prabhupada, my holy master, his divine grace. More than bosom friends, so loving you would warmly embrace. It was predicted by the Mahajan, Sri Bhaktivinoda Thakur, from all over the world, devotees would gather at Mayapur. Exactly like Srila Prabhupada, in a Vaishnava family, you did stay, as his father, Gaur Mohandev, would earnestly pray. O holy men, O sadhus, my son, do bless. To become a servant of Radharani was his address. Your guru you met also by her grace, a ray of Vishnu, his divine grace. Your Guru Maharaj and Swami Maharaj were so pure, both very dear to Saraswati Thakur. That fearless preacher, Sri Dayita Das, named his disciple Abhay Charan Das. Engaged in kirtan and bhajan to Sri Hari, he named your beloved guru, Sri Binod Bihari Brahmachari. By serving you, we actually come alive. To thou lotus feet, I will always strive. Like Srila Prabhupada, you shower your mercy to all, low or high, as he was a Shaktavesh avatar, an expansion of Sri Nitai. You distribute Gauranga's teachings, which make perfect sense, and you said we will get Premanam if we chant without offense. It is at Sri Radha Kund, the most intimate place, that you hold dearest to your heart, which you embrace. As I watch and listen to you, though I am so lame, I see Srila Prabhupada in you. You both are the same. On Jamastami day, Sri Radha called her most intimate friend, saying, tomorrow on earth you will descend. You also accepted Srila Prabhupada as your spiritual guide. I pray to you, Gurudev, to help me get rid of my pride. By attachment to Guru, all will be known. In my heart you have entered, that seed you have sown. At Sri Radha Damodar, his bhajan, Srila Prabhupada would perform. Starting a world movement, he would reform. There he lives eternally within his rooms, where Radha Padaseva blossoms and blooms. You helped him so much to spread Mahaprabhu's mission, because both of you share the same vision. If Sri Radha is pleased, our fortune will thrive. Srila Prabhupada said, she asked me to preach. Pray to Radhika, and you will definitely survive. Why can't everyone understand how much you really want to help your soft, loving heart, that you continue to help as you did from the very start? You are giving us orphans some hope. You are the world's spiritual mentor. And by properly hearing, Sri Nam, Mahaprabhu, Sri Rup Sanatan, and Raghunath will enter. In my heart, my eternal dandavats to Sri Radha I make, staying sometimes in Vrindavan, Govardhan, or Sri Radha's lake. In Kartik, Sri Radha's month so sweet, your beloved Gurudev, enter Nitya Lila, but we hold on to your feet. On our own merits, we will certainly wither, our hopes will die. So in our hearts to Krishna, we must fervently cry. Srila Gurudev, savior of the world, for that you lit a lamp and gave us a place to reside at Govardhan and Sri Radhika's camp. Srila Gurudev, you demonstrate how material existence is full of strife. I pray for that day when to you I fully dedicate my life. In a distant lifetime, for that I yearn, for that I pray, when my life can actually be yours in total someday.
You are very dear to Sri Krishna and Srimati Radharani, and to the world you speak pure Gauravani. It is only on your mercy, which is my life, on that I draw. You live Gauranga's precepts, to be more humbler than a straw. This humble servant of your divine grace shall sing of your glories in every place. Though still on the ways of ignorance, I restlessly toss, forever I will call out to you, weeps Devendranath Das.
Nirgun Prabhu. I request him because he was serving Swamiji from his beginning days when he was like a young. He has sacrificed everything for him and still he is serving. I'm also debted to him, he is helping me.
Oma gina timinandasya gina gina sadakaya chakshuru militamena tajma shivarve nama manchika putrubhyascha kripasindhubhivacha patitanam bhavanevyo vaishnavevyo namo nama. I feel so fortunate to be here today. There are so many places one could be, but to be here is, it's like heaven. I feel it's like the beginning of a divine festival that you never want to end. And by the way, at this time I want to invite everyone to our house, and maybe in sometime in May we'll send flyers to everyone to come, because we're going to have another festival like this in May or June of this year, and Maharaj will be there. This is in Badger, California, and we'll send this. I'd like to describe the circumstances surrounding Maharaj's visit to my house. Actually, it was amazing. I was a couple weeks before he came, or something like this, and I was walking around the corner of my house, and a thought came to me that some saintly person is going to come to my house. And I was just a thought, and I thought, this is interesting. I've been lamely practicing Krishna consciousness, superficially practicing with trying to keep it alive with my god brothers in Badger. And so at any rate, I heard some devotees speaking that one Srila Narayan Maharaj was coming to Badger. And I thought, oh, this is interesting, you know. And then I heard some devotees speaking that he cannot stay in my house, as the landlord does not want him to stay. And so I said, well, he can stay in my house. And they says, oh, he can. And I said, oh, yes, it'll be nice. And then time went by, and actually coming in from different quarters, I heard some positive things, some negative things. And I thought, well, I am not going to, I invited this sadhu to my house. I'm just going to, I don't know, I'll just treat him like he's a pure devotee. That is how I'll go about this. Mm-hmm. And Srila Narayan Maharaj came to our house, and I was so amazed. A few days, day after day, it went on, and it got simply sweeter and sweeter, just like Krishna consciousness. And I was realizing it is something like the Bhagavad Gita. If you approach it in a humble way, in a submissive way, then some message can come, and you will understand something about Bhagavad Gita. So in the same way, by taking this stance, I figured I'll accept him as a pure devotee. And then I'll be able to see, at least I'll be able to see what he really is. In the end, I'll be able to make a good decision. And actually, I have still not been able to estimate my good fortune. It's amazing. I'm hearing so many wonderful things, and I'm most unqualified. But I Srila Prabhupada, he could encourage us by just his glance, by his few words, he would encourage us so much. And this is the same quality I find in Srila Narayana Maharaj, that by his association, we are feeling so much encouraged in our spiritual life. Encouraged to go on and develop our Krishna consciousness. I simply offer my respects and humble obeisances to everybody, and I thank you for allowing me to be here with you. Hare Krishna.
Shri Krishna Lila Kathane Sudaksham Audarya Madhurya Gunaischa Yuktam Varam Varenam Purusam Mahantam Narayanam Tam Sirasanamami Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Ram Ram Hari Hari. First of all, I pay my humble obeisances at the lotus feet of my initiated Gurudev and instructed Gurudev simultaneously, Srila Bhaktivedanta Om Vishnupada Parivrajaka Acharya Varja Ashtotra Satasishmad Bhaktivedanta Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj and Om Vishnupada Parivrajaka Acharya Varja Ashtotra Satasishmad Bhaktivedanta Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj. After that, who assembled here to hear Harikatha, I pay my obeisances to them also. There are so many excellent devotees. They express their experience and idea at their best. I am Novin, that means neophyte. I shall try at my best, which they keep for me as a rest. We are hearing about Guru Tattva. We have heard this morning Srila Gurudev explain so many things about our Param Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. Few years before, Srila Maharaj explained and a comparative study about Satya Yugas, Guru and Disciple, and Treta Yugas and Kali Yugas. So I try to memorize all these things. You know about Aruni and Uddalak. Uddalak sent his disciple Aruni that rain is, this heavy shower of rain, rain may come out from my field, please stack it any somehow. He went, order of Gurudev. He could not check the water. At last, he full flat to check the water. Then Gurudev came in last night and asking, oh Aruni, where you are? He replied, very lean voice, oh Gurudev, I am here. Gurudev asked, what you are doing here? Oh Gurudev, you ordered me to check water, I could not do so. So by my body I am checking water here. Then Gurudev told, all Vedas will be manifest in your heart. So he serves Gurudev. What is his destination? By serving this, he in these 14 lokas, not beyond of this. After that, I taking another example of Guru Seva, who is Srila Maharaj told this morning about Dronacharya and Ekalabha. Ekalabha want to learn archery from Dronacharya. His motive was to defeat Arjuna and to kill Arjuna. Arjuna is a very great devotee and friend of Supreme Personality Godhead, Sri Krishna. Dronacharya told, no, I could not teach you. So he went jungle and made a statue of Dronacharya and want to worship him and learn archery from him. One day Dronacharya went jungle with his disciples, including Arjun, and there was dog with them, with their party. It was barking. Then so many arrows came and police mouth with no crutches, no blood, nothing else. They became surprised. Who is that archery? Archer. We know so good archery that no blood came and dog could not barking. What happened? Then they followed dog and they saw that one very black person sitting there. Dronacharya asked him, what are you doing here? From where? How? From whom you have learned all these things? He told, oh Gurudev, I am your humble disciple. Then he told, if you my disciple, then you have to Guru Dakshina. Yes, Gurudev, what you want, I can give you immediate. Then Dronacharya take his thumb as a Guru Dakshina. Why? Then he could not shoot his arrows as well as before. So what is his destination? He was opposed to Arjun, opposed to Krishna. So in the battle of Mahabharata, he killed by Krishna's Sudarshan Chakra. Destination? That Brahmalok, not more than that. And today is whose appearance day, Srila Gurudev appearance day. Why, how he serves Gurudev, I want to say something. When he joined in Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshava Goswami Maharaj, beloved disciple of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, he surrendered himself in the lotus feet of his own Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshava Goswami Maharaj, and tried to serve his best. What he want, he want to try, he try to fulfill his desire in every respect. When Srila Maharaj used to cook for Param Gurudev, Param taking prasad, can understand that Srila Maharaj cooked this for him. And our Param Gurudev was so fond of Srila Gurudev's cooking. He knows who is cooking, only taking, oh, this is his cooking. Param Gurudev can understand. So he surrender himself with heart and soul and serve him at his best. So what is his destination? You know everything. I don't want to bother you. So I am telling that Krishna se tomar Krishna dite paro tomara sakati ache amito kangal Krishna Krishna boli dhai tobo pache pache. That is service Gurudev. That is destination, the best destination for jivas. That Mahaprabhu came in this world, that samarpaitu munnata jalarasang savakti sriyam. Gurudev is explaining for few days that Mahaprabhu came in this world not to distribute unnata jalaras, what he want to taste. That means radhaya pranaya muhima kidrishobana yiva saddo janadhuta madhurima kidrishova madhya saukhan chasamadanu bhata kidrishang veti lohvat tadbhavadda samajani sachigar vasindau harindu. He want to fulfill these three desires, Krishna. So he came in form of Mahaprabhu, taking the beauty and mood of Srimati Radha Thakurani. He came in this world. He can distribute this unnata jal ras. What he want to distribute? Rasang sabhakti sriyam. The beauty of unnata jal ras, this is also unnata jal ras. But Mahaprabhu came to distribute this. And what you want to taste, he can distribute this. Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami mercifully quoted in his Chaitanya Charitamritam that premaras nirjas korite asadhan ragmarga bhakti loke korite pracharan. That he want to taste the essence of premaras and want to distribute ragmarga bhakti. How one jeev can achieve, can go through ragmarga. So Srila Maharaj, Srila Gurudev came in this world for this thing, to distributing rasang savakti sriyam. He established in this and is so merciful, karunaya vidravan deha. He's thinking, oh, I am testing so good thing. Oh, they are suffering. Oh, why I cannot help them? If I help, and they can taste these very good things. So, being causeless merciful, he came in this country and want to distribute all these things. Just like as before, you know, Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur distribute all these things, and he have to oppose so many, facing so many opposite things. In this period also, Maharaj mercifully want to distribute all these things, but he have to oppose, he have to facing all so many opposite things. Yet, he is determined, no, I shall distribute all these things which I am testing. Just like Sri Rupa Goswami is telling in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Seva sadhaka rupena siddha rupena chatrahi tad bhava lipsanakarja braja lokanusarata. That he is serving just like Rupa Goswami Pad, serving Mahaprabhu, and same time divine couple. Vais jathavastit deha, that means in sadhak form he is serving Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and preaching, and is on his own form, that means in the servitor of a divine couple, he is serving divine couple. So his destination as a maid servant of Srimati Radha Thakurani. So Srila Gurudev want that we should be one day that maid servant of Srimati Radha Thakurani. This is the best goal of jivas in this planet. Nothing more than this. So Gurudev mercifully distributed all these things. I am praying him, his lotus feet also. He is serving his Gurudev. I want to serve him, same mood. And I pray him that one day I will be in the same way in which mood you are serving Mahaprabhu and divine couple. You know, touch stone. If you touch any iron, they transfer to gold. But who is Vaishnava? Is qualified Gurudev, they never do so. There is one chopa in Hindi that paras ar santame vishesh antarjan, paras sona loha kare santa kare ap saman. That means if you touch iron with gold, touch stone, it transfer into gold. But who is bona fide Gurudev in line of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he never do so. He who come in his touch, he transfer them like him. He, just like a bona fide Gurudev, make all devotee guru, not to disciple. Apsaman means like him. So I am praying him from my core of my heart that please be bestow your mercy, then I can serve you just like you are serving your Gurudev. Hare Krishna, Bancha Kalvataru Bhascha Dipa Sindhu Bhaya Vacha Parita Nankavani Bhogasana Dhyana Namo Namo.